What's going on, YouTube? Robbie again, and today we're going to be taking a look at something a little bit different. This time, it's going to be my first official Nerf gun review, and this time we're going to be looking at the Toys R Us exclusive Dart Tag Snapfire 8. Now, the thing that kind of drew me to this was that it says it has dual firing modes. It's got a fast firing mode or a long range mode. So I'm assuming that it's like you can slam the trigger and then just keeps firing them out, or if you switch it, it takes, I don't know, it'd only do one shot at a time, but it gives it more oomph? I'm not sure. But really, I was drawn in because it says, trigger force technology, one-handed, no cocking, so you just, it's just pull the trigger. That's it. No pulling back, no batteries. Just one-handed, so you could totally dual-wield these things if it works the way it says it does, and so that's why I was curious enough to pick it up. Also, it's a pretty decent design. I'm not a huge fan of the yellow and black dart tag designs. They're a little bit futuristic, and when you try and paint them, they end up looking kind of cheesy. But that's all right. I'm going to paint it anyway. So I can't wait to get this open and see how it actually works. So that's what I'm going to do, and I'll see you guys in a minute. Alright guys, so here is the Snapfire 8. Like I said, it's a Toys R Us exclusive. It's one of the Dart Tag Nerf guns, so it's got the kind of weird yellow and black sort of futuristic motif going on here. And it's very interesting. I was curious as to how this thing would actually work. And it's pretty cool. So basically, you pull on the trigger here, which I guess primes the air pump while you're pulling it back. So it does take quite a bit of force to actually pull that trigger back. But I'll show you really quickly. No batteries, no cocking. You just do that, and you can fire it off just like so. And it's got a little dial. You see speed, power. You turn the dial here. It takes quite a lot of turning. And once it's set to power, it takes quite a bit more force to pull the trigger back, but you get a much more powerful shot. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause the video here. And we'll take it outside and actually see how far it can fire. So I'll see you guys in just a moment. Okay, guys. So here we are outside. So please don't mind the background noise. It's the way it is. I can't make the birds and cars shut up. So we're gonna give a shot to the Snapfire 8 here, and we've got it. I'm gonna set it back to speed. We can take a look and see what we get here. All right. Let's see the distance and as how fast I can actually pull this trigger. All right, let's go. All right, so that went about maybe 5 yards or so, 6 yards at the most. Not terribly far. Yeah. Between 15 and 20 feet. So we're gonna knock it down to power, and we'll see what we've got going on here. All right, power. See, that second one didn't go any farther than the others. So I don't know. Maybe I pulled the trigger too quickly, or what? But so you're looking at, I'd say 25 feet or so at the most for this particular Nerf gun. Not terrible. And I mean, if you take into consideration a couple of things here, no cocking. You could totally dual wield this pistol if you wanted to, and that's always I guess a plus in some respects. No batteries. You don't have that god awful spinning up sound that you get with guns like the Barricade or other sort of motorized guns, but you still get rapid firing. So I think overall this is a really, really nice addition to the to the Nerf gun lineup. I think probably you'd want to use it mostly for close quarters, though, because over distances, you're just not going to get that kind of power out of it. But overall, definitely nice. This was like $20 at Toys R Us. It's Toys R Us exclusive. I think for the technology and what you get with it, it's a decent deal. So I'm happy with it. I may paint it up. I don't know. Like I said before, these shapes usually don't look very good painted, at least in my style. So we'll see what happens. But either way, it's a recommend from me. I do like it. It's definitely a good. It's an excellent backup gun. I do wish it had some sort of clip, because I know the other Nerf guns usually have a clip for, you know, for a carabiner or something like that, so you can kind of put it on your belt or whatever. This would be definitely a good backup gun. So yeah, that's gonna do it for this review, guys. I want to thank you so very much for watching. As always, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And I've got a lot more stuff coming down the line, so I'm gonna get to that. I'll see you guys next time. Bye for now.